Some people think climbing in the summer is rock climbing season. They're not right. All hard climbing happens when it's cold outside, but there are some tricks. Here are my tips to climbing in the fucking cold. Tip number one, start with warm shoes. Don't be a savage. If your shoes aren't already warm, first thing I do, turn them sole side up and put them in the sun.
Tip number two, climb in the sun.
Bad, good. Bad, good. Why climb when it's 30 degrees outside? Well, it's Saturday in Eldo. Look at all those people. Look at everybody. Tip number three. This is kind of low hanging fruit. Bring a stove. Two-part process here. You can use the stove to warm your hands. You can also find yourself a nice rock. I like one that's thick and smooth edges. What you can do is put the rock on the stove. I'm gonna let that get nice and hot, and then that rock is going in my chalk bag. I have gotten the rock too hot and it's melted through my chalk bag. So there is a little bit of a sweet spot here. The hot rock trick actually goes really well in conjunction with tip number six, super circulate. Caliente. Tip number four, wear layers. When it's cold outside, resist the urge of wearing the thickest jacket you own. We're not climbing Everest. Instead, rock layers. I start with a long sleeve shirt and a t-shirt, because honestly, that's what I end up climbing in. On top of that, I like a synthetic layer. This is sort of an alpine hoodie. I like synthetic because I'm gonna sweat in it and I don't want it to get all soggy. It's close to my skin. This is something I can climb in. For belaying, I add a down parka because you gotta stay warm. Ninja trick, always have an extra large down parka. Everyone can wear a down parka that's an extra large, but not everyone can wear a small. If your belayer gets cold and wants to go home, it means that you have to go home. So bring warm things for your belayer so you can send. The most crucial layer for climbing in the cold is long underwear. If your legs are cold, you're gonna be cold. Another thing you can do to stay warm is get a pair of shoes that have a built-in liner. Like these bad boys from Tolson Tulf, they have this built-in kind of fleece liner, sock that goes into the shoe and the shoe's lined with some felt. Game changer, you can still climb hard, but your feet stay nice and toasty. But someday you'll pay. Tip number five. This one pertains to humidity. When it's super frozen like this outside, the humidity is really low. And while the common understanding is that you want your hands to be dry while climbing, when my hand is absolutely dry, I'm gonna use this window as a reference here, my hand is gonna slide over the window really easily. There's almost no friction. So when it's really cold out, I like to artificially introduce a little bit of humidity to my skin to allow that kind of friction at the chalk skin line to be a little tackier. To do that, I bring a little spray bottle with water in it, just water. Give my hands a mist. Then I would apply my chalk, just a light mist. With that light amount of humidity added to my hand is tacky against the glass. It doesn't just slide like it did before. So when it's really cold, it's one of the few times that you want to bring in some moisture to your skin. Tip six, when it's truly Arctic, like it is today, the high in the sun is 21 degrees. Keeping your hands warm is difficult, so we have to go to desperate measures. For this one, super circulation. Learned this one from Tommy Caldwell. Don't even try to keep the hands warm in the first place. Find you some snow or water, pull up them sleeves. What you're gonna do is deliberately numb your hands out. This water is real cold. What I'm gonna do is keep it in here as long as I possibly can. My hands are gonna go completely numb. So my hands are totally numb. It hurts. It just start warming them up. My hands are real cold, but as they warm up, they're gonna get hot and puffy. And there's a window there or your hands will never get cold again. And I find this the only way to make it work when it's really cold out.
I have kind of a hard cutoff. Rock climbing below 20 degrees is a bit heinous, so I try to stay about there. As you can see, today is windy, snowy, and below 20 degrees. I think today's a rest day. Tip number 7, when it's really shitty, rest.
Or you can do some toughness training. I like to go climbing when it's Arctic out because consider this, if it was 17 degrees on the Cassine, it would be a balmy day. So might as well get used to it if you ever want to climb an alpine route.
Simply must go.
Baby, it's cold outside.
The answer is
but
no.
Baby, it's cold outside.
The welcome has
how
been
lucky that you dropped
so
in.
Nice and warm.
And for tip number 8, I'm going to give you something that rather than helps you climb in the cold, but helps you decide whether to go climbing. Today in Denver, the high was 32. I'm standing here in the shade on the east side of my house. Temperature is 27 degrees. You would say it's too cold to go climbing. But if I just walk over here to the south side of my house, the way I find out if it's warm enough to go climbing is I walk outside, I stand on the south side of my house, close to the house where the wind doesn't affect it, and I check the temperature here. And as you can see, it's 68 degrees. This is gonna give you a good idea of what the temperature is like at the cliff. I also use the facade of the house to see if the rock is gonna be dry. As you can see, this side of my house is really dry. Whereas if we come back around to this other side, it's still pretty wet and there's some moisture all over the place. So this helps me decide that I can't go climb at an east-facing cliff. So I use that aspect to make the decision of where I'm gonna land up.
For tip number 9, my tips to warm it up when it's cold outside. First thing I do is called the muscle hustle. I stole this one from Angie Payne. Thank you, Angie. Sit here, right here. Now obviously you can go for a run or something, but if you're kind of in a small spot on a ledge, whatever, you can't, you might look ridiculous, but I'll do this for 2 or 3 minutes, kind of get the blood flowing. Next thing I do to warm up the shoulders, I grab me a rock here, and I do these, call these halos. I hold it here, passing around my head one way and then the other way. And you can do this back and forth until your shoulders get really nice and warm. Once I've gotten a good warm up there, I like to head over to the cliff. And again, if we're sport climbing, we don't need a place to traverse. We are bouldering today, so I could traverse. And all I do is I grab holds and do short static hangs. So quick hang here, hop off, maybe I grab a different hold, quick hang. In between the static hangs, I'll take my hands and I put them together between my legs and I squeeze my thighs together and I run them back and forth as hard as I can. You'll get a lot of friction warmth here that kind of like penetrates deep down into your fingers. And I find doing that and getting back on, grabbing the cold rock, doing those short static holds back and forth, it's probably the best way when it's really Arctic.